Anything yet?
I am Groot.
Guardian of Galaxies.
Cosmo, buddy. Where have you been? We've been calling you.
Sorry, Peter Quill. Cosmo's ball has been tied. Universal Church of Truth arrive at nowhere.
What? Are you okay?
He's fine for a moment. Cosmo receive warning in time, but Continuum Cortex is of shutdown for safety. He's been dead, huh?
Your little detective trip almost got us killed. We'll fill you in when we get there.
Yet. This problem is bigger than Cosmo. Guardian of Galaxies must go to Xandar and ask Worldmind for help instead. Cosmo unable to get through. Guardian of Galaxies must actually...
Cosmo, are you there? What happened?
I am Groot.
We under attack.
So these are the cowards who defiled Lady Hellbender's honor.
Oh, good.
And who the flark are you?
Normally, I would not engage in conversation with inferior life forms. But my contract with Lady Hellbender stipulates otherwise. Therefore, abomination. You may refer to me by my title. I am Captain Glory, leader of the Lethal Legion.
Lethal Legion? More like Loser Legion.
He surrounded us.
Listen, I get that Lady Hellbender's super pissed, but now's really not the best time.
Did you think that she would ease her bounty simply because you somehow managed to elude the Blood Brothers in nowhere?
Yes?
Then you are as imbecilic as they are. You will not elude me. That I can assure you.
Need a few minutes. Stall him, Quill.
Why? Where are you going?
Did you mute me?
I am Groot.
What?
I am Groot.
You keep repeating this same meaningless phrase.
So, Lethal Legion. Cool merc name. I used to run with the Ravagers myself.
We are far superior to you and your Ravagers, Terran scum. The Lethal Legion is composed of the best warriors the universe has ever seen. And me.
Hey, look. I get it. You're the best of the best. You're the captain of a super elite team. I'm the captain of a... elite team.
Some of us are super elite.
You are nothing like me. I am Glabri of the Kree Empire. My birthright alone supersedes any sense of worth you foolishly believe you possess.
Spoken like a true Kree.
More like an arrogant a-hole.
Enough! I will not be disrespected. You will be eliminated.
Give it your best shot, Helmet Head. The Milano's gonna blow you out of the sky.
Your ship doesn't have that kind of firepower.
Scan again.
Possible.
Just a little something we picked up in the quarantine zone.
Looks like you underestimated us.
We'll see.
Hit them hard and give no quarter. There's nothing on that garbage scow worth salvaging.
Groot, find us a channel with less butthole content.
Got a piece of that guy!
These ships ain't dying fast enough!
There's an art to this, Rocket. We're artists! We're taking fire!
Try not to get shot, Quill.
Flying, this sucks!
Finish them!
Just getting started.
I would love to hunt you down.
And feed your ego? No, thank you.
Good
Feels kind of good to have bounty hunters after us. Means we're making a name for ourselves, right?
Not sure how much we get out of taking down Captain Craphole and his legion of crap.
Drop out and get a better angle if it gets too hot.
Or feel free to point the guns right at him and charge.
Where's Drax the Destroyer? My bounties are fine as you.
Ain't a bad question.
These guys have really bad timing.
Starting to wish I'd stayed in dog jail. Feel free to show off, Quill. They insulted my baby.
Just keep watching.
Hang in there, bud. They ain't killed us yet.
Jeez, how much money did she offer these guys?
More than that Ravager is worth, thief. Hit them hard and give no quarter. There's nothing on that garbage scow worth salvaging.
Groot, find us a channel with less butthole content.
The Blarkers are forcing it open somehow.
Feel free to panic. Your dying cries will be recorded as proof of your demise.
Drop out and get a better angle if it gets too hot.
Or feel free to point the guns right at him and charge.
Can't we just send an IOU to Lady H?
I ain't paying that psycho a single unit!
Please try to flee. I would love to hunt you down.
Ain't nobody running, you Jawhawker.
Feels kinda good to have bounty hunters after us. Means we're making a name for ourselves, right?
Unlike you, I have done my research, Peter Kill.
These guys have really bad timing.
Another problem for our pile of problems.
Where's Drax the Destroyer? My bounties are fine as you.
Ain't a bad question.
Jeez, how much money did she offer
only
these guys?
Only one lethal lame brain left.
Woo!
Who's the inferior life form now, huh?
Still you.
Peter, I'm picking up something.
What?
It appears I'll have to finish this myself. So you defeated my fighters, but my cruiser will crush you. Feel bad, Guardians.
That's it? That's what you've been bragging about?
That did some real damage. Keep hitting his exhaust ports.
Your strategy won't work.
Thanks. You just confirmed that it will.
Lady Skullshoot is the worst flark in timing!
Keep up the barrage. They will not survive it.
It's really pissing me off! Off the whole galaxy!
He's chewing us up, Quill.
Moron! Protect our points!
This guy's starting to sound like Rocket.
It's called language efficiency, Quill. Yeah, I don't think these scrap sacks care if the galaxy's under siege. You know, contractors.
We're contractors! You okay in there, Cap?
Stay still and I'll shoot.
Just kill them already!
That was a bad hit.
Ooh! Right up the exhaust port! Taking heat!
That hurt. take better care of the Milano.
Yeah, you were a ship wash and a wax when this is all over.
Right after you patch up all the holes.
Wonder how much these creeps are getting paid for killing us.
Let me look up the contract real quick. My ship!
No, you don't. What little?
That scut stain just shot us.
That was a lucky shot.
If you get us killed, Quill, I'm gonna kill you! Where are you going, Quill? You're making us an easy target!
Turn around or we're dead! Then do something about it.
Feel bad, Guardians?
Nope, not a thing.
The Milano definitely felt it.
Keep up the barrage. They will not survive it.
That did some real damage. Keep hitting his exhaust ports.
Your strategy will work.
Thanks. You just confirmed that it will.
Moron. Protect our point.
This guy's starting to sound like Rocket.
It's called language efficiency, Quill.
He's really pissing me off.
He's chewing us up, Quill. Shoot us the worst luck in timing!
Is she here?
No. Just her goons! This
time! I am Clary! Warrior of
Take that, Lady Skull Scut!
I doubt we've seen the last of her.
We'll worry about Lady Hellbender later. Let's just focus on getting to Xandar. Punch it! Girl needs a tune-up.
We can do it once we reach the station.
I ain't letting no buckethead near my...
Wow. Talk about cosmic gridlock.
I haven't seen this many ships around Xandar since the start of the Galactic War.
Open a channel, Groot. Let's see what's going on.
These ships come from converted worlds.
They're refugees.
Need immediate docking permission. Please answer us.
Groot, that's enough.
I don't see any rescue shuttles coming out. They're ignoring them.
No. No, 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 no. Nova Corps might be a bunch of self-righteous domeheads, but they're supposed to be helping folk. That's their whole flarkin' deal.
Relax, Rocket. We'll just call the station and ask to speak to the World Mind. Groot.
Welcome to Nova Corps headquarters.
Please state your preferred language of communication.
Quill, I'm gonna gnaw your ears off.
I am Groot.
I know, bud, but now we can all follow along with Starpan's mistakes.
How may we assist you?
We need to reach the world mine, Peter, and doing nothing won't work.
I am Groot.
Groot's picking for you, because you're too slow.
We should report what Raker is up to. Just pick something, Peter.
After scanning your ship,
our near-perfect algorithms pre-selected
several officer choices.
We are
sad to inform you that Denarian Carlos
is currently missing and assumed dead.
Hey, isn't this that Buckethead we killed on the rock?
We definitely did not murder him, and definitely did not admit it in front of a Nova Corps console rocket.
I am Groot. I am Groot.
Groot wants you to pick World Mine.
Nova Prime's identity is confidential.
And communication with them is forbidden.
Until further notice.
Huh. Doesn't say which one. Why even list them then?
I am Groot.
Scroll down!
Hey, your cop girlfriend is still listed here.
Corbin Day is missing in action.
And unable to respond.
Heard of him. He was in the Resistance.
So much for near-perfect algorithms, helpline. Hey, Woolberry, got any ideas?
Ugh, I hate bureaucracy.
Scroll back up. I think I saw someone interesting.
Nova number 11249-44396
is out of our sensor range and unavailable for contact.
Richard Ryder. Sounds Terran.
You seriously don't know who he is?
I have yet to meet a Terran of any interest.
This menu again? Does that say Nova Prime? Any idea which one?
Who even cares?
Centurion Corel's personal communicator
has either been destroyed or disabled
and could not be reached.
For what it's worth, I'm sorry, Quill.
Me too.
Peter, I think everyone here is too busy or dead to answer.
Neglect Gold's communication privileges
are suspended while we investigate
her involvement in unsanctioned cult activity.
You should force your spawn to answer us.
I can't do that. She's independent.
Congratulations on your decision to join the Corps. To begin, state your full name,
designation, or serial number.
Richard Ryder.
Star-Lord. Quill's mom!
This strategy is futile.
Oh, come on, Muscle Brain. It might work.
Not today.
Nope.
Please state your celestial body.
Or artificial installation of origin.
Someplace.
Earth.
I continue to doubt this strategy.
Yeah.
Finally,
in a few words,
describe what made you want to join Nova Corps.
Because I'm a sucker.
Force justice.
Looks like the best AI in the world couldn't parse that.
Duck boys.
Alright, so that was fun, but a complete waste of time. Any other ideas? How about future crime?
Great idea! Let's report something we're gonna do and blame it on some other schmuck.
We are aware of the current threat, but
and devote no resources toward fighting it.
Thank you for being proactive.
However, the galaxy's impending doom makes
all future crimes irrelevant.
We should tell them about the promise.
Right!
Due to the imminent termination of civilization,
we are unable to open new cases.
Do you think turning ourselves in would get their attention?
Thank you for attempting to be an upstanding citizen.
As all prisons are being evacuated,
you may self-sequester
wherever you wish.
I am Groot.
Connecting.
I can't believe that worked.
Guardians of the Galaxy.
Explain yourselves.
Hey, World Mine, long time no see. It's me, Peter Quill, Star-Lord.
And, it's Guardians of the Galaxy. Check the addendum.
We need your help.
To pay a fine?
No. No, of course not. You need to save the
galaxy. Cannot be saved, Peter Quill.
What?
A mass delusion known as the Promise
is sweeping its systems, converting all who encounter it.
In less than three cycles,
it has spread from the crew of a single star frigate
to multiple outposts,
worlds and systems.
Praxius 9, Rigel 3.
75.222%
of the Andromeda galaxy,
all lost.
Of course, she don't mention Contraxia.
They, actually. The World Mind is a collective consciousness.
Look, we know who's behind the Promise. We've seen it happening up close and personal. We're here to pass on information to you so you can stop it.
How can we be more clear?
The Universal Church of Truth
cannot be stopped.
Told ya, they're a collective.
It is a machine.
Yeah, well, so are parts of me. And you better not call me in it.
I'm Groot.
At least Abomination sounds scary.
Look, we just escaped the Church's mothership. We have a ton of intel you can use to bring them down.
There is nothing you can tell us we do not already know.
Pretty sure I know a few things that even a supercomputer can't know.
Such as?
Well, how to groom the feathers on a Shi'ar warbird, for starters.
Are you still alive?
Because I know how to groom the feathers.
Yeah, well, I know where you can buy hack Nova Corps helmets at ridiculously discounted prices. What? They obviously don't know about it, or they'd do something.
The point is, we've lived things, experienced things. We've survived the Promise, and maybe our experience can be used to help you bring them down.
It is possible.
We have overlooked the value of individual
experiential memories stored
within our files.
Good. So let's pull resources.
However, given the ill-defined
parameters of such a query, undertaking
a search protocol at this time is
ill-advised.
Now, if you will excuse us.
The Universal Church of Truth's forces
draw closer to this region of space.
It is critical that we depart before they arrive.
You're running away?
What about the refugees? You're just gonna leave them defenseless?
Our primary directive is the
preservation of Xandarian culture. All else is secondary.
Have you seen what your planet looks like? Xandarian culture is a lost cause!
Culture is more than a location.
And yet after the Chitauri attack, you still build the new Xandar in the same system knowing it wasn't safe.
Where would you even go?
Please understand that we are not
able to disclose information of this nature
to untrustworthy parties.
Untrustworthy my tail.
And how long are you gonna hide from the Church, huh? Millennia? Bolennia?
As long as it takes.
And if you try to come back, you'll be completely outnumbered.
Xandarian culture will be preserved, but it'll never be safe again.
Point taken.
Nevertheless,
we must
leave.
Why?
For unknown reasons. The
Church is stockpiling resources.
Its influence has grown beyond all probabilistic
models.
Then update your models.
We cannot adjust our computations to the
enemy's nonsensical power source.
You mean faith energy?
Faith, as an energy source,
is illogical. We are unable to
compute scenarios to fight that which should
not exist.
So you're just gonna let the Church win?
If the power source cannot be quantified,
it cannot be countered.
Most sentient beings don't have the luxury of calculating their odds before getting into a fight.
That is why they fail.
Ha! Drax, he's as dumb as a stick, and he ain't failed so far.
Don't you control the Nova Force, the magical energy that powers Nova Corps?
It is not magical.
But yes.
Then how do you explain that one? Because to an outsider, it doesn't seem logical at all.
Thanos used to say it was generated by the living computers of Xandar.
The living computers of Xandar
are the Nova Force. It exists because we exist.
And we exist, therefore it does.
Sounds like you're able to harness your collective energy just like Breaker with other people's faith. Maybe the way you do it can tell you how the Church does.
Perhaps. You have given us new data to consider.
Guardians of the Galaxy, we will.
Later. Right now, we need to
focus on our departure.
You're still leaving?
We did not
make this decision without considering all available options.
A complete search
of our databanks only revealed
a single entity with the potential
to stop them.
What is it?
Not what. Who?
Adam Warlock. The Church's original golden god.
Unfortunately, he perished
in the last year of the Galactic War.
Great. So no one?
We are
pleased you reached the same conclusion
we did.
It appears that our travel preparations
are almost complete. Farewell, Guardians
of the Galaxy.
No, wait!
Classic Nova Corps. Ain't helped us then, you won't help us now.
I am Groot.
What? Are you kidding me? Groot says the Flarkin helpline's still asking for fine money.
All right, let's get this over with. Confirm payment.
Oh, what? Whole universe is about to end and you spend our cash on a Nova Corps fine.
Look, dude, the Church is about to come for all of us. Once that disabler goes off, we'll be sitting ducks. All right, at least we got that sorted. Let's get out of here.
Peter, we've got movement.
I'm Groot.
They're taking off. Well,
I see it.
Son of a schmack.
You're accepting the promise.
We gotta jump, Quill.
I know.
Petra's promise is becoming real.
Peter?
Gotta get clear first.
Come on.
And go!
What did you do?
I don't know.
Why have we stopped?
The Loser Legion must have hit something when they ambushed us.
Guys.
It's only a matter of time before the galaxy accepts the promise.
Sacrosanct is back there. We can't just sit here.
Guys.
And how are we gonna do that? We're dead in the Flarkin water.
We're screwed.
Freely accepted.
Oh yeah, and without an engine, we're screwed anyway.
Guys. Enough. Just stop already. I can't hear myself think. Rocket, fix the engines.
How am I supposed to do that? I can't even run a diagnos-
I don't care! Just fix it!
Scoff.
And what are we supposed to do?
I don't know, okay? I can't just conjure up answers every 2 seconds.
Fine.
Don't. I just can't do this right now. I need some rest. Screw Nova Corps. Shouldn't have counted on them in the first place. Drax, I
do not wish to talk.
Fair enough. We're all pretty spent. Just try to get some rest if you can.
Look, it's our great leader. If you're about to throw another tantrum, do it quietly this time. Hope you can hear yourself think now. Probably isn't much to hear anyway.
Hey.
Here to yell at me some more?
What? No.
I really don't feel like small talk.
You forgot your toast.
Hey, Groot. You remember if I left the sensor nodes on standby earlier? Because I told you about it. I said, Groot, remind me to something something the sensor nodes. Yeah, I remembered most of it, but I'm missing the middle part. Ah, I should have written it down.
Hey, how's it looking?
How does it look like it's looking?
Well, I...
Tension circuit melted through the stem bolts, reverse ratcheting routing planers out of alignment, can't even see the Flarkin sensor node behind the flux capacitor.
Wait, flux capacitors are real?
What? No, I mean flow capacitor. Words get a little messed up when I'm tired.
As long as it's not a bomb. Really? How did you... Oh, I'm gonna get fleas. We sure had good times, didn't we?
Stop humming! I don't care if the breathy water sewer likes your singing. I need to focus.
Come on, girl. Shoo, shoo. And the bed smells. Great.
We have a ship. This is our room? Why is it so small? Look at you. Me.
Who?
Weird hair.
What? What is it? What is this? How are you... me?
Come on. The talking raccoon's waiting for you. Everybody is.
Rocket, yeah. He was fixing that thing that broke.
Hey, if we're some kind of big space hero now, why are we running from the bad guys?
It's complicated.
No, it's not. Stop running. And we've landed.
I'd betray Yondu all over again if it meant doing the right thing.
Groot wanted to let you sleep. Can you believe it?
How long was I out?
Long enough to fly us all the way to the quarantine zone.
Wait, how do we fly out here?
Quill, do you want to fix your ship or not?
My ship!
Yes, your ship. Come on, the others are outside.
I'm glad to call you a friend, Gamora. Let's be careful out there. The quarantine zone wasn't exactly safe last time.
Don't worry, I remember the sudden debris showers and the aggressive wildlife.
Remember when you jumped around on an old Chitauri bulkhead to prove a point and it collapsed?
What am I doing? Everyone on this ship's been using this. Not today, brain parasites.
So what's the plan here? We just picking up any junk we find?
Not any junk. We're here for a second-tier catalyst with a blotting handle.
Huh?
Plus, I'm missing an optical induction cable adapter. If we can find a plasma hutch box, we'll be halfway there.
A box? Right. I know that word. Be nice while we're running errands, all right? And please, stay out of my cabin. I wonder if we should bring her back to where we found her later.
So you flew us all the way here?
Yep.
Without asking?
Hey, I asked. You said, and I quote, "I'll take you to the stars. I'll show you who we are. We're space riders with no name." And then you went back to sleep.
And you thought that meant yes?
Good enough for me.
I should probably learn a second language at some point. Like French.
Gamora scouted up a Chitauri installation not too far from here.
What's in the Chitauri place?
Looks promising for spare parts.
Is everyone outside already?
Yep, waiting for us. There, let's go!
Look who stumbled out of bed.
The rodent made decisions in your sleep.
Yeah, I know.
Took you long enough?
What? Nikki? I'm not supposed to be here.
You promised you would get me out of here.
I know, but... Nikki!
Guys, don't let it get to you!
Won't have to tell me twice!
Quill!
Quill.
Peter Quill, wake up.
Drax. We talked about this, man. You gotta stop.
Your illegitimate child was correct, Peter Quill. Hovat and Chimera will be restored.
Okay.
We just need to have faith.
Drax, you're kind of freaking me out, man.
I had to share the good news, Peter Quill. You have lost your family. Your mother. The Kree woman. You understand the pain that comes from loss.
Drax.
But with faith, with the Matriarch's promise, our families can be restored.
Drax, I don't...
You have accepted her promise, have you not, Peter Quill?
Not exactly. But not because I don't want to. It's just... I have questions.
I understand. The Matriarch's promise is overwhelming.
Overwhelming is a word for it.
It also took me time to see the miracle of her promise.
Yes, time. I just need... time.
I will give you time, Peter Quill. However, I am less certain of the others. The Wooden One may come around, but I suspect the assassin and the rodent will resist.
Mm-hmm.
This makes them a dangerous element to our cause. I must eliminate them.
Wait!
Why?
They're our family, man. Just give them a chance. It's a lot to process.
You truly believe they will accept her promise?
I know it. Take Gamora. Her dad was Thanos. There's gonna be some stuff to work through before she can accept it. And Rocket. Where to start? He's literally a walking science experiment. What Nikki, the Matriarch... is offering, it's all new territory for him.
And the Wooden One?
You said it yourself. He'll come around. I mean, it's Groot, man. He's our rock.
Very well, Peter Quill.
Good. That's great. I'll let the others know.
No, I will fetch her and bring her to you.
How? She's like a million light years away.
We have already landed on our planet. Think well, Peter Quill. When I return, she will demand your answer.
Wait! Drax! We can talk about this! Great.
Yo, Quill, you there? Please tell me you're not dead. Quill?
I'm here, Rocket!
Oh, thank Flark.
Peter? Rocket? Why is my door locked from the outside?
Yeah, Drax may have kind of joined the church.
What? Seriously?
I am Groot.
I know, it's super messed up, Drax. Drax is kind of messed up. He also may have landed us on Sacrosanct to find the Matriarch. But don't worry.
Don't worry?
Yeah, be happy.
Might be able to activate the Milano self-destruct sequence.
That's your plan?
What, you got a better one?
A little hard to concentrate with Peter singing.
I'm thinking!
Think somewhere else! Stop singing!
For your information, Cammy finds my voice delightful.
She's the only one.
That's it. We're locked in, but she's not.
So, she's an idiot.
Doesn't mean she can't help us. Can you transfer ship schematics to my tablet? Maybe get me a camera feed.
Yeah, okay. Why?
I want to check where Cammy is.
Done. Go ahead and grab it. What are you thinking, Quill?
Okay, I see her. Gamora, sing something, anything.
Why?
Just do it!
This is me singing a song, I hope you like it, because
oh,
I don't.
Wow, she hates your voice.
Fuck you!
It's good! She responds to singing. Maybe if we direct her to that panel near the cockpit...
The emergency door controls.
Yes! Just keep singing. I'll use the PA and try to lure her to chew the lock override. She chews everything.
No. Peter, do I really have to do this? Cammy's... Is this even working? La 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 la. Join a team, she said. It'll be good for you, she said.
Hey. La da 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 da. Don't worry, be happy.
Something, something. Note for note. Peter, do I really have to do this? I mean, Cammy's a space llama. One who apparently doesn't even like my voice. Ugh.
Don't worry, be happy! Blah,
be happy.
I can't do it no more! I can't and I ain't!
Okay, come on, girl. Give it a little nibble.
Do what you do best, you toothy bastard.
Guys! I think she's doing it! I can't believe it worked!
We're not at the Sacrosanct. We're on a planet.
Well, that's a Flarkin relief. Let's get the scud out of here before Drax comes back with his new best friend, the Kratakin Matriarch.
Rocket, stop! We can't just abandon Drax.
Is he even still Drax? I mean, he's been converted.
I know. It's just we need to find him and pull him back from the dark side.
You're talking about kidnapping Drax the Destroyer.
Emphasis on Destroyer.
And we've come too far, seen too much awful stuff to abandon one of our friends. Drax is still our friend.
That ain't our friend no more.
Don't make me pull rank on this, man.
Are you pointing your frickin' guns at me?
No. Not yet. I just need you to understand how serious this is. We're not leaving.
Well, Flark, Quill. It's about Kratakin time you showed some Nords. Fine. I'm in.
Any other objections?
Nope. I'm good.
I'm Groot.
Good. Then let's go find our friend.
For a rubber ducky grenade, I'm gonna bite your toes off.
Really? Nothing at all? All right.
Just want to make sure you're up for this.
Don't matter, Quill. I'll try anyways.
If everything goes right, we'll be back in no time.
And if it goes wrong, well, somebody's got to extract your butt out of there.
Ready to go out there and get Drax back?
Ready? No. But the longer we wait, the further he'll drift away.
So, how about now? Ready now?
Peter, it's gonna take more than 50 ticks to think of a plan.
I know you're ready.
I am Groot. I am Groot.
Ugh, Groot says let's go get him.
Okay, here we go.
Not this place.
You know where we are?
In a Flarkin lagoon? How many times I gotta tell you people, I don't like water!
Hey, I didn't land here, okay? Drax did.
Ah! This stuff is gross! Are you kidding me? Wet fur is the worst!
Rocket! You alright?
That's it! I hate water! I hate being wet! And I hate not getting paid!
We're not here to get paid! We're here to save Drax!
What do you mean the plants here are strange? Everything here is strange. Are those even trees? And what are those?
I'm Groot.
Yeah, well, the Milano's your home.
Guys, this is Lamentis, home of the priests of Pama.
More religious nut jobs. Great.
They aren't nuts. They're pacifist exiles.
Pacifists. That's even worse.
I am Groot.
You saw them on nowhere?
So how do you know this place?
I came here after a job went bad.
What kind of job?
It involved my sister, and it's not relevant right now. If Drax thinks this is the Matriarch's planet, something's off.
I'm fine.
The village is this way. Smell that ocean air. It's so calming.
Ain't nothing calming about that.
It grows on you, like an old friend.
So vast.
Tell me we ain't crossing above an ocean and...
Only part of an ocean. Don't fall, you won't get wet.
Yeah? Well, how do you know Drax didn't fall?
Quit worrying, Rocket. Anything happens, Gamora will jump in after you.
I will?
She will?
Yes, because we're a team. And Gamora's the most sprightly.
I think I'd rather drown.
We should sink on our plan for when we find Drax.
Shoot first, plan later.
We're not shooting Drax.
But you were willing to shoot Rocket?
Yeah, what does Scott Quill?
Drax is the one in need right now, and I'm gonna do whatever it takes to help him. We all are.
Found Drax!
Where is she? Where is the Matriarch?
Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Put him down!
Drax! Buddy, just calm down!
No, she called me here to mend the lost.
Rocket, a little help here!
Hi, guys.
Mantis?
How did you...
What? Oh, that? Lysau once taught me the art of striking one spot and many times. There's an Omphad who teaches me later. Don't worry, Green Meanie's fine.
What are we doing here, Mantis?
I told him to come. On nowhere. I saw time inside his mind. The lies that bind. I mean, what's a girl to do? Whisper a course correct, obviously. Shh. It's okay. Stay with me. Quiet in the dark.
Another one of your girlfriends, Quill?
Oh, no. Not this time. Come on, The creepy cave's this way.
The what now?
The creepy cave, where the darkest of our future paths will meet. Dark as in unknown, not as in bad. I mean, it might be bad. But no way can it be worse than the futures I did see, because those were definitely bad, very bad. You don't want to know how bad.
Can someone please translate her?
I am Groot.
The point is, or was, or... Which parts of the point have I made already?
The creepy cave.
Yes, that's right. Big strong heart carries so much sorrow inside. In all futures, he's the one who turns. And in some, we save him. Here! And here we are, where the Kotati take root.
So, just to be clear, there's a timeline where me and you...
Peter, focus.
Right. What's a Kotati?
I am...
Plant people, like Groot, but, lame.
The Kotati are a highly evolved, highly sacred race of pacifist beings who grace us with their meditative powers. They also guard the secrets of the ancient cave.
Can they temporarily unguard it?
Oh no, they take this duty quite seriously. Our only hope of entering is to appeal to their infinite wisdom.
I am Groot!
And we're in!
What are we looking for in here?
She doesn't know.
Something that's gonna help Drax.
We're all just taking the word of this space case.
She's not a space...
Ooh, spooky!
Spooky is right.
More like deadly. Are we sure about this?
Nope.
Maybe Drax just needs to sleep it off. I mean, he seems fine. Ish.
My telepathic control won't last, little fuzzy. Only Green Meanie's friends ever help him see through the Matriarch's lies. And it only happens. Watch out!
Double floor!
Whew. I almost didn't sense that one in time.
Everyone just remember we're here for Drax. Though, it would be easier if we had some idea of what we're looking for.
Oh, for sure. It's always easier when you know things. Like,
no, but you don't.
Not yet.
This place reminds me of the quarantine zone and all the wrong ways.
Whoa! This place is really unstable.
Fuzzy Cave's gonna kill us all.
Oh, no, not all of us. Not this time.
Let me get this straight. Something, somewhere, in this dank, dark cave will save Drax. More water? What's wrong with this lousy planet?
Doesn't seem that bad.
Seems deadly and cold and wet.
Just keep moving once you're in.
Ha! Nice!
Whatever you found in there, Quill, pretty sure it ain't worth getting drenched for.
Spooky, right? The Kotati mentioned the faces in the dark before, but I always thought it was metaphorical.
I'm sure it'll get drier from here on out.
Oh, you were so wrong, Stir Fry.
Stir Fry, that's a good one.
You? Yeah! Giddy up!
Crap! That was kind of close.
That one sometimes gets Gamora.
I doubt it. You're sure we're headed the right way, Mantis?
I think so.
Okay, well, it's too wide to jump here. We'll need to look around, find another way.
Hi-ya! Giddy up!
The head case ain't even talking galactic anymore.
I spotted a little mousy hole here.
Groot, maybe if we all push together...
He
says it would need Green Meanie's help, but Green Meanie can't help. Until you help him.
Any ideas, Gamora?
Only one. I don't think he can help us right now.
What do you think, Rocket?
I think you need someone big and strong and green to knock it down.
Oh, no. I can't make Green Meanie do that.
Let's take a look through here. Maybe there's another way to cross. All right, Gamora, let's get up here.
Why don't I just blast some of these rocks?
Oh, no! I don't trust him not to kill us. What's your reason?
I have seen so many futures where Little Fuzzy dies in this cave.
Rocket, you feeling lucky?
I got this.
Yo, geniuses! This thing above me don't look too sturdy. Knock it loose and we got our bridge.
Try your blast.
Still ignoring the bigger problem of not knowing what we're looking for.
Don't focus on what. Focus on how much he means to you.
Of all the times Drax has done something for us.
Name one time.
Remember when he saved our butts in that mining ship?
Scoff. He saved your butt.
He drags a lot of heavy things around. And thrown rocks. Seems to love throwing rocks.
Throwing rocks is a proud Kataphian custom.
You feel it too, Sir Groot?
Wait, you can understand him?
You don't? Oh, Gamora, I saw the cutest little doll when I was on Nowhere. You'd love it. No, wait. You aren't gonna like it.
Well, which is it?
I guess that'll depend on who you are when you're there.
This is a lot of trouble to go to for a freaking colleague.
Tell us how you really feel.
I just did. I mean, if push comes to shove, we can get another big guy.
Admit it. Drax means a little more to you than that.
Fine. Maybe a little more. But not a lot more. Not die in a cave level more.
I am Groot.
What do you mean it's not a good look? I'm being honest.
I am Groot.
I do not secretly love Drax. Ew, gross!
Drax has definitely been there for us before. Like on Sechnarf. First time we got jumped by that tiger with the squid face.
Oh, Stumpy?
And the second time we got jumped by Stumpy.
Mantis? Should we be worried about this fog?
Stumpy? Take it back. Having normal Drax around would have been useful just then.
What are the odds of those things living on this planet?
Maybe they weren't native to Sechnarf? And this is where Hellbender first got them?
Or maybe Hellbender's here, tracking us across the ends of the galaxy.
Because she wants us dead.
Lady H wants us dead. You realize what that means?
We're all gonna die?
I think I see what he's doing.
It means we're a team. When we piss someone off, we piss them off together.
I'm gonna assume that sounded better in your head.
Water, fog, and monsters. What's the forking deal with this place?
There has always been a great power here. The priests tell tales of those who were here before them, and what wonderful things they could do.
I don't remember hearing anything about that.
You weren't ready to listen last time you were here.
I am Groot.
Oh, no, Sir Groot. There's no such thing as the Kotati root.
Why were you here again, Gamora?
Oh, I know the answer. It's the same across all timelines.
I told you. I was here to recuperate. I was in a bad place.
We had to keep an eye on her.
You sure that's the right way, Peter?
I'm sure that it's not, but let's not tell Star Guy. He needs to learn for himself.
I can hear you!
Even better!
Yeah!
Nebula wasn't your fault, Gamora. You know that, right?
What's she talking about?
Nothing.
I should give this to Drax when he's himself again.
The priests never talked much about these caves.
Oh, they wouldn't. Way too dangerous down here. Unseen forces, ominous machinations, unknowable energies. There's a reason the Kotati guard the entrance.
Of course there is.
Groot says we should check things out over here.
So, what's causing these unknowable energies?
I have no idea! But if I had to guess, it probably has something to do with the previous civilization. But they disappeared millennia ago.
I can still feel their shadows.
What the flark are we supposed to find down here again?
Fear faced fully from far within.
Or something like that.
It's the something I'm worried about.
Want to talk about it, little fuzzy?
Talk about what?
The pain. Fear.
Ooh, spooky.
We ain't being watched. No one in their right mind would be in this Krutflakken cave of flarkin' wonders.
What's going on?
Sir Groot feels the intrusive eyes watching us. Don't worry, my Flora, I feel them too.
What the flark?
There's two of them!
Two of what?
Mantis, do these things have anything to do with what we're looking for?
Inconclusive.
Drax better appreciate
but I'm
how
thinking
dangerous
no.
This dumb plan is. What do you think, Quill? You best friends?
Yeah, maybe not.
communicate with these ones!
Using charge now! Chop chop, Gamora! Proof! Hard time
I should know these ones! Boo-boo!
This is what we get for following the Bug Lady!
I feel like a matador!
You're gonna feel something else if you don't watch it!
Not for lack of trying!
Oh, I remember this part. Something bad happens here, something we have to avoid.
Mantis?
Over here.
All right, I like Drax as much as the next guy, but I am officially sick of this stupid cave! Who, Bug Lady? She couldn't guide her way out of a bathroom!
Are you the rock face we're looking for?
Not sure if I wanted to answer or not.
Whatever gets us out of here.
Green Meanie's lost in an ocean of lies. We need to bring him ashore, but we also need to remain grounded in the positive. We're his lifeline.
Positivity isn't exactly our strong suit.
You always underestimated yourself, Gamora.
Looks like there's something on the other side.
Too bad Drax is out of it. I'm sure he'd love to punch a giant face.
Rocket, think you can crawl in there?
For what? So I can get eaten by whatever lives inside?
The stone faces. Whatever we're looking for is beyond or beneath or behind one of the faces.
What do you say, Rocket? I bet you can find us a way back there.
Fine. Whatever. Ugh, smells like rotten spike eggs in here. Okay, setting the charge. Stand back!
I don't think this is the one.
Crystals are kind of pretty.
Yeah, I've seen better formations. These look like regular silicates.
Oh, there's nothing regular about the way they resonate, little fuzzy. We each need to face our fears. Some here, some not. But facing them is most important.
You know, running is sometimes good too.
For you, yes, Star Guy. But only until it isn't. You'll see that soon enough. No, wait, you should know that already. Don't you remember your dream?
How do you know about that?
Dunno, I just do.
There's that feeling again. The fur on the back of my neck is sticking up.
I feel it too, like a pair of eyes watching me. About this place, Mantis.
Did they happen to mention the part where it's super dangerous and stupid to enter?
Oh yes, it's very dangerous. Ancient even. An ancient danger. Or what? Still is. Something.
Hey, Groot, buddy. Think you could lift this?
I'm Groot.
Up we go.
No, there ain't nothing he needs to know about me. Keep your barkhole shut. Your bark's crawling. I'd almost jump into the water if it made the creepy crawly feeling go away.
In there that could save Drax.
Is there another face somewhere, Mantis? Mantis?
Huh? Oh, yeah. This cave is multifaceted. Get it?
Heave it, Groot!
I am Groot.
That's good. Up we go, Groot.
I am Groot.
Right about there.
I am Groot.
Over here.
You, see something out there, Mantis?
So many things, too many things. Shadows of a civilization that lived here once before? Forlorn faces that can see, like me, horrors yet to come? And other shadows, too. Ours? Not ours? A figure that's watching us now. Or was watching us then?
I see rocks and, crystal things. A statue that looks like a face, and more rocks.
I like yours better. I see something else. I see friends willing to die for another friend.
Yeah, well, I'm hoping it doesn't come to that.
Me too, Star Guy. Me too.
Found another way.
Just me or them crystals look super dangerous.
Don't worry your fuzzy little head. You only die from a great fall in two timelines. This probably isn't one of them.
We need to get on those crystals, Groot.
Just let Quill get out there first. I don't want you falling.
Definitely remembering something now, I think. We need to be careful here.
I think what you're seeing is some version of me pushing you off a cliff.
Oh, little fuzzy. Your volatility is surprisingly consistent through all versions of time and space.
Maybe we need to accept that not everything can be explained. The galaxy's a weird place. Just gotta go with the flow.
Getting lost in a deadly cave is your idea of going with the flow?
We aren't lost, little fuzzy. At least, not in this version. We're recovering what other versions of us have already found. Isn't it exciting? If you want to stop Rooker...
Raker.
Right, Router? This is the only way.
Whoa.
finally, the face of a thousand lies, I think.
It's gonna help us save Drax.
It tries to keep us from saving him. We seek something behind the face, beyond the lies.
You want me to blow it up?
That shouldn't be our answer to everything.
Here goes Doofus! Scott! Watch out, everybody!
Finally, the face of a thousand lies, I think.
It's gonna help us save Drax.
It tries to keep us from saving him. We seek something behind the face, beyond the lies.
You want me to blow it up?
That shouldn't be our answer to everything.
Here goes the Scott! Watch out, everybody!
Nice landing, Scott guy.
Thanks.
You don't usually make it. The Kotati mentioned the faces in the dark before, but I always thought it was metaphorical.
Bug Lady is absolutely bonkers. Of course I'm angry. I'm what? Wandering around a cave that's falling apart, looking for Flark knows what! Flark, I'm going in.
No, you mustn't!
You don't want me to cut the thing?
Wait, no, not you. Something bad is about to happen.
Oh, that's it. I'm going in.
Fuck it!
Blow up this statue, save Drax, and get out of here!
Yes, but...
Time to start trusting our instincts, Quill. Bug Lady said the face is keeping us from helping Drax, so we gotta destroy it.
Little Fuzzy, don't do whatever it is you're about to do.
No. I'm done with all the riddles.
Don't do whatever you're about to do.
Just hear Mantis out on this, okay?
Give me a tick to think, okay?
Not if the whole place collapses.
But at least you wouldn't have to argue with him anymore.
Not helping.
Groot, can you tell him to stop?
Little Fuzzy's in a mood. We're probably gonna die. Yes, but...
Mantis, does he kill just himself or all of us?
Neither! Bug Lady is full of lark! Stand back! Just plug this to this thing.
Rocket, don't!
One.
You can say that again.
Oh, I will.
Mantis.
Where is the matriarch?
This is the one where I fail.
We're trying to help you!
It's okay. One where I fail is the one where you don't. Shh. Stay with me.
Hey, guys! Check it out! I'm totally not dead! What?
You almost killed all of us! No more blowing things up, Rocket! Ever!
You're gonna regret saying that.
Sergei! Are you Spartoy? Why didn't I know that? Maybe you aren't always... Or I forgot.
What?
Those guns do something again, Quill?
He saved Drax after you almost killed us all!
How'd a gun do that?
Show him! Star Guy!
That's how it's done.
Eh, me exploding stuff is still better.
It's really not.
Next time we're in a huge fight, you're gonna beg me to blow stuff up. Beg me!
Next time we're in a huge fight, I'll make sure to remember that.
Yes, it's all coming together like a zipper. You just have to push ahead or enter another head. No, wait, no, yes.
What's she on about now?
More of that weird fog.
Be glad you ain't this close to the ground.
Oh, Little Fuzzy never dies from gas in here. Just falling, crushing, Chitauri,
wait,
water...
Wait, hang on. Did you say Chitauri?
Oh, I did, didn't I? Such a funny-sounding word.
This is impossible!
I thought I'd never see these Flarkers again!
I hoped I never would! Kill them all!
So many possibilities! Always moving!
You couldn't have warned us that Chitauri were hiding out in this cave!
They aren't always! Just sometimes we just try to see them with eyeball dyes! You know what I'm talking about, Scarecrow?
I'm familiar with eyeball dyes, yes! What I don't get is why they'd be here!
Feel free to ask him! It's like the worst timeline! Swatting him!
busted open the Nova Corps crackpot! Okay, this is officially too weird!
Hey, can't blame this one on me!
Took down one of the Nova Corps nut jobs!
Bog of fear, faced fully forthright.
You okay, Mantis?
Oh, hey, Gamora, you look less depressed. Wait, we went over that already, didn't we?
Yeah, we did.
That thing of yours is still bothering you, though, right?
What thing?
I'm fine. Let's just focus on helping Drax.
He's gonna be upset he didn't get to fight all those things.
I don't think that any of those were real. Not really real, anyway.
Their attacks felt real enough.
Maybe they were real. There's something down here that's affecting my vision.
Don't think it was ever that clear to begin with. Just how far down does this cave go?
Legends say the entire planet is hollow!
Heads up! More than rock monsters.
Maybe we just got off on the wrong foot.
I don't think they're looking to make a mess, Will.
Maybe I can help. I think I speak their language.
Who would want to live in this hole?
Doesn't exactly get a lot of sunlight.
About as well as expected.
I was sure. Oh, maybe I just haven't learned it yet.
I think I picked up the word for kill. Or the grunt, anyway. The fog doesn't seem to bother whatever these giant things are.
Maybe they're just smart enough to not wander around in it. Unlike some people. I know why we're doing it, and don't think Drax won't hear all about it either.
Oh, is this the one where Little Fuzzy does something heroic? Hard to say.
I think it's pretty easy to say he won't.
You, most of all, should be willing to give someone another chance, Gamora.
Everything here is strange. Strange plants, strange fog.
You sure that's the right way, Peter?
I'm sure that it's not, but let's not tell Star Guy. He needs to learn for himself.
I can hear you!
Even better!
Cure Drax, we should make up a story about how we battled some epic, one-of-a-kind monster.
Oh, you won't have to make that up.
Just gonna assume you got your timelines crossed again.
Sunlight, does that mean there are holes on the surface that lead all the way down here?
Maybe that's it. All these jerks who keep attacking us fell in and got stuck.
This looks like something Gamora could use.
Planet be hollow? Doesn't it need a core or something for gravity or atmosphere?
Got any other science words you want to throw out there, Gamora?
Electromagnetic field?
Don't make no sense.
What doesn't?
How come everything attacking us don't attack each other? Guys.
I know, Little Fuzzy. And it is the only way forward.
What's happening?
He sees what lies ahead, and I see what lies behind.
No way! No flarkin' way!
Doesn't seem that wet. Like, medium wet.
I ain't walking through a flarkin' monsoon!
Maybe there's a way to use those plants to divert the water. We're a team. We'll figure it out.
Are we seriously gonna let this keep us from saving Drax?
Sure! You save him while I drown!
How does it even grow down here?
I don't know. But those big leaves could be useful. Like a dam.
Dam what?
No, it's... Yes!
It's just a plant, not a you plant. And we ain't got much choice.
What do you think, Rocket? Doesn't seem that bad.
Translation. Rocket, don't...
Rocket don't like wet. We get it.
It's a scary dark cave. We're all probably gonna encounter things we don't like.
True. But nothing as much as Little Fuzzy doesn't like getting wet. Never underestimate someone's deeply rooted fear, Sir Fry. Especially when you do not understand the root.
What would you guys do without me?
Yeah! Where, oh where, will we get another gun?
It must still be stuck somewhere. Still holding on.
Gamora, let's climb up there. Get eyes on the problem.
The problem is that Rocky needs to suck it up.
Yeah, good luck with that.
In Little Fuzzy's defense, he has died drowning in far less water than this.
Exactly. Wait, what?
This doesn't seem absurd to you?
He's got a thing with water. What do you want me to do?
You're supposed to be his leader.
Have you met Rocket? Here, the almighty Star-Lord.
You say something?
God, nope.
Bullseye!
Remember last time you blew something up?
Okay, fine. Figure something out.
Just like that!
Please, don't give him an even bigger head than he's already got. Hey, Bug Lady, exactly how many times you seen us die horribly?
Oh, it's too sad to count. I always have to stop around 50.
Great! That's 10 apiece!
Oh, no, 50,000, Little Fuzzy.
Less wet.
I'm 0% interested.
Right, I'm on it. It's actually kind of refreshing.
Like a quick shower.
What do you say, Rocket?
I ain't ever showered either, and I ain't gonna start now.
Group, let's see about crossing.
Says no way, not without me. Glad someone's got my back.
There are timelines in which Little Fuzzy moves mountains for you. In this one, you must block an ocean for him.
Ocean? Really?
To him? Yes.
Sure, they're big enough to block the water, but they're growing in the wrong direction. You're the only plant that grows that fast. No, it ain't none of their business. What's to understand? I ain't a fan of drowning.
Missing Drax's anecdotes about Katath.
Oh, you know he has some Katathian fairy tale related to our current situation?
Like the Katathian equivalent of Jack and the Giant Beanstalk.
Easy, Green Meanie. They'll figure it out.
Hey, Groot.
He ain't gonna let you leave me.
It's not that. I just want some help up here.
All right, he'll do it.
Mantis, any of those realities where we just leave Rocket here, hypothetically speaking?
Oh, yes.
Anywhere I don't kill them all for abandoning me, hypothetically speaking?
Oh, Little Fuzzy. Sometimes you die trying to get out.
Hey, if I jump, you can catch me, right?
Guess we'll find out.
That's not very reassuring.
Just don't screw up the jump.
Ah!
Why don't we just leave him behind, focus on saving Drax? He'll still be here on the way back, and if he isn't...
Groot would never go for that.
What are you guys talking about?
Nothing, buddy. Too bad you don't have these sweet guns, Rocket.
Keep it up, and I'll swipe them in your sleep. Huh? What's your hurry? I told you to go before we left the ship.
Nice shot, Peter.
Thanks.
Try to ask it to move, but I don't think this is one of them smart plants.
Let my rocket go!
Huh?
Moses!
Are we supposed to know who that is?
Part of the seas guy?
Oh, with the tentacles, right?
What? No!
Anyway, thanks, Quill. Really.
I was pretty sure he had tentacles.
What do you say, Groot? Now that we got the whole team together?
Absolutely. A dry rocket is a happy rocket.
This is you happy?
Oh, yes. You should see some of the dark versions of Little Fuzzy. Or maybe you shouldn't. You really, really shouldn't.
Does this crab corridor ring any bells, Mantis?
Pretty sure this is the wet part.
But what now?
I thought we just did the wet part.
Oh, it gets worse. Much worse.
Guys.
Everyone okay?
I'd be seeing stars if I could see anything at all.
Yeah, this ain't good. So, about all them futures where we die.
Has he always been able to do that?
He says he don't like showing off.
Thanks, buddy.
No, I don't gotta tell him.
Ooh, right. The thing that you tell us in the dark. It's really important.
No, it ain't! Shut up!
You're among friends, Rocket.
It's nothing, okay? Just... the lab I was in did tests on me in tubes of water. And it sucked. It really, really sucked.
Sensory deprivation experiments on Half-World. I heard of those.
Sensory deprivation was like a vacation compared to the other things.
And that's why you hate getting wet. Clark, I had no idea.
Don't make a big deal out of it. Just prefer to keep dry is all. So how long do we gotta wander around smashing our shins on rocks?
Imagine it's a metaphor. You're in the physical darkness, and that reflects green light.
Fucking visor!
It ain't a flashlight, Quill. Remember back in the dark in the quarantine zone?
I thought that was some funky energy thing.
Funky energy in the dark. Groot's bioluminescence ain't exactly on the defined light spectrum. You don't know.
That it's not, but let's not tell Star Guy. He needs to learn for himself.
I can hear you!
Even better!
Next.
Well, you find anything shiny, we split it.
This part.
Okay, anyone else getting really fed up with Little Miss Cryptic? Pretty? Give me a break.
At least it seems less dark through here, and less wet.
Works for me.
Mantis, anything in particular we should be looking out for?
I'm trying to remember. I think this is where it gets loopy.
Now it gets loopy?
There's that creepy fog again.
It's always here. Always. Until it isn't.
What's that supposed to... I don't...
More Hellraisers.
Wait, yeah. But it ain't those Flarknards. It's them creepy eyeball things from the QZ.
I'm definitely hearing Hellraisers.
Then you ain't hearing right. It's eyeball things.
I can't tell. It's not clear.
Well, it's clear to me. These ears don't lie, lady.
I think I can tell the difference between Lady Hellbender's minions and some giant bugs.
Mora's gotta be right. We already know Hellbender's goons tracked us here. Has a mind of its own.
Not mind. Force.
Can we go back?
I'm not even sure where back would lead.
We go down. Always down.
Anyone else getting deja vu?
It all looks the same with this fog.
Well, it don't sound the same. It's them jelly things from Sekhmar. That explains Stumpy's cousin.
No, it's Novacor. I hear voices.
How can you not tell the difference between monsters and people?
It's not that. We're clearly hearing different things.
Kor's right. I hear voices, just like when I put on that helmet in the Nova base.
You're both crazy. Sums it up.
At least there's a way out now, I guess.
Okay, now that's them bouncing eyeballs from the QC. No question.
I'm not doing this. Something is clearly messing with us.
Chitauri? Okay, well, that's just wrong. You're worse than her. Those overgrown lizards make clicky sounds. You got moss in your ears.
Something isn't right.
I hate to say it. I mean, I really hate to say it, but it does sound like those squishy eyeball things.
Okay, I'm officially tired of being right.
Even when we're right, we're wrong.
This cave definitely looks the same as before.
It's a cave.
Sorry to burst your bubble!
This sure beats therapy!
How deep can this go?
It's endless. Or circular? The fog calls and we answer.
Anyone else feel like we're being messed with? Yeah, I hear it. What is it?
This isn't right. It can't be real.
Sure felt real when we were fighting them.
It's the fog. They're just sounds.
Shh. What do you mean, shh?
Tell us right.
Shh.
And about what?
Shh.
So it was nothing.
I think it depends. It's got something to do with the freaky fog.
Every time you name an enemy, it has the power to make that enemy appear.
So the key all along was to keep quiet?
Yeah, like that was ever gonna happen.
I saw so many versions of us fighting so many different things, but the source? It's not done with us yet, Guardians.
Yeah, well, let's just keep our eyes open and our mouths shut from now on.
The fog entity has retreated for now. There's no immediate risk.
Yeah, no offense, Bug Lady, but nothing you say means anything anymore.
So the fog is an entity now?
Yes! Sort of.
Ugh.
Don't be frustrated, little Fuzzy. We're all still alive. That's super rare!
Obviously, if some fog monster is trying to kill us, it means we're getting closer to whatever it is we're looking for.
That kind of makes sense.
And if this fog monster can make bad things appear, maybe the opposite is true. Like, if we all say cure Drax, maybe that's what we've been looking for the whole time.
I wish, Star Guy, but no.
The one time she gives a definite answer.
Ooh, do you all feel that? We're so close.
You finally figure out what we're here for?
No way. But I do know it won't be very easy, especially not for you.
Where are you going, Quill?
Just following my gut on something.
Tough to say what happens next, Sir Groot. I only know that if we succeed in helping Green Meanie, we stand a chance. The cosmic energies will realign and a new series of possibilities will emerge.
That sounds confusing.
Definitely. Possible timeline, we all get smushed.
Great!
Let me guess. Further down?
Only if you want to save Drax and the whole galaxy.
Let me get back to you.
Okay. Look, guys, I appreciate what you all did for me back there with the water thing, but following the Bug Lady any deeper is officially stupid.
Rocket.
No. Fog monsters? Cave pigs? Wet waterfalls?
Technically, all waterfalls.
No, Quill. She doesn't know where we are. She doesn't know where we're going. She doesn't know what we're looking for!
Mantis, are we hot or cold?
Room temperature.
Okay. This is crazy. She is probably crazy. It's not about her. It's about us. I am super proud of us. Because we've never gone this far for anything before.
Oh, this is the one where you inspire them.
Just think about who we were when we started.
Well, you were a two-bit broke pirate who couldn't even outrun a tree.
Exactly! And you were a two-bit bounty hunter. Just as broke as me, just as depraved, self-centered, mindlessly chasing every unit, bar, contract, bank to rob.
I still like many of those things.
So do I! But none of those things are why we're here now, right? You're down here, kicking ass for Drax. Not Drax the Destroyer, not Drax the Rampaging Criminal. Drax, man! And Gamora, you've gone to the ends of the galaxy to hunt people, to hurt people, to get revenge in what I can only assume are some excruciatingly painful ways. But doesn't this feel kind of good? going this far to help someone you care about?
Oh, it feels so good.
And Groot.
He says you don't have
to. No, I do. Because we all need to learn something from you, man. You never complain. Or if you do, I don't catch it. But I'm pretty sure you probably definitely don't. You're always there for us. And that's what this is about. Us. Growing together as a team, following a crazy lady into a death cave because one of us needs help. Because we are a team. Help, we're a family. We're the fucking Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yay!
Really great speech, Quill.
Why didn't anyone stop me?
You're on such a roll!
It really was one of your better speeches.
Luke, you're up! See a lively Drax again.
I'm about to make him deadly. I mean, you know what I mean.
He's going to leave behind the statue, Sargon. The evil must be stopped from within. You get that, Peter?
Yeah. Tell him about the statue.
Can't we make it create something friendly?
Can we just blow the statue from the inside?
That opening's filled with water, Quill. Find me another way in.
Your shadow
selves will never stop. We'll never die until you kill the source. The giant...
Rocket, you see what I see?
Yeah, I can get in there.
So let's throw this thing to hell!
Don't know how much longer I can hold this off, Peter!
I knew I was good there! How was that?
Did it work? Feels like it should have worked!
Then why are we still fighting?
I'm thinking all it takes is one more blast.
No, the water, Quill. I can't. You know I can't.
Rocket.
No, keep shooting. It's gotta end sometime. That base is a Run, buddy.
Mantis.
We gotta nuke the statue! Rocket, you gotta try!
Be brave, little buddy!
I'm gonna take out every last one of these markers!
You gotta take out that head!
It will never end, little buddy! They will keep fighting until the source is completely destroyed!
Suck it up and do it!
Be careful, little buddy!
You got this, Rocket!
things work. Come on, Rocky, you can do this. You can, right, Mantis? Mantis!
Rocket, check it out. Still not dead.
I can't believe you did that for us.
Hey, a friend needed help. Bunch of them.
Rocket, man.
Can we please just save Drax already?
Warm? Very, very warm.
I think she wants us to jump in the hole.
I may not know what we're looking for, but I know it's down there.
Okay, let's finish this, because I sure as Flark didn't get all wet for nothing.
We need to hurry! I can feel the Matriarch's lies getting bolder and Green Meanie's mind!
Hear that, Wolf? The kid's getting stronger!
Oh yes! This is the place! I was pretty sure we'd find it somewhere down here.
Now you know what we're looking for.
Something sad and sulking, licking lingering wounds.
If it's here.
She's totally gonna feed us to something awful down here. I know it.
Should we expect a fight?
Probably. You guys aren't very good at the whole de-escalation thing.
You're kidding. Even with our prize negotiator over here?
In a very small, fractured universe, Star Guy ends up being as charming as he thinks he is.
Doesn't matter what's down here. If it can bring us back our grumpy Catathian, I'm all in.
And the rest of you should be too. Come on, guys. We're the freaking Guardians of the Galaxy.
Is that supposed to be me?
I've heard you make that speech so many times. And then Gamora says something like,
we're going to need Drax?
Uh-huh. And then Little Fuzzy says,
nope, I ain't playing this game.
And then Little Fuzzy usually says, if I get eaten, I'm gonna be real pissed, Quill!
That does sound like me.
Relax, nobody ever gets eaten. We're here. Home of the healing light. Source of the cure. Origin of Rager's power.
It's a cocoon?
Told you she was gonna feed us to some giant bug. Or maybe she's the bug, and that's some kind of external digestion sac or something.
You realize this is weird, right?
Oh, it gets weirder.
What the? Oh, gross! Please tell me Drax is the only one who's got to go in that creepy egg sack.
So the shepherds found fresh flock. Foolish followers.
Think fast, beard butt!
You know not the gravity of your treacherous trespass. You cannot quell a god. Prepare for oblivion, interloper.
Oh, it's this one. Okay, Green Meanie, you're up.
Found you.
nasty uglies from that busted noggin of yours.
It's okay, guys, it's him! Aaron Witchcraft! No, wait, Aiden Warsock! Ashley Warsock?
Adam Warlock?
That's it! The Golden God guy!
Hold on. This guy's Raker's old divine whatever?
Looks pretty good for a dead guy.
Were you not sent by the sanctimonious shepherd?
Us? With Raker? Not a chance. We're trying to shut his ass down.
See? Friends. Okay, big guy. In we go.
Come on! All the ones where we die already happened.
Raker's got half the galaxy going cuckoo bananas. Her friend included.
I swapped your ass for a newer, younger blue-skinned model.
So, can you help us? Mantis seems to think he can cure Drax.
My heavenly healing is veiled malignance. A first folly I swore never to repeat.
Can someone translate this guy?
He said no.
What protection I can proffer is to remain reclusive.
Not this time, Goldie. The pieces need to go back together. We just gotta get you all closer to the puzzle.
And that would be...
in here, of course.
Oh, wait, let's talk about...
what the butt?
It's like the beginning of Space Odyssey.
Welcome to the Astral Plains, Snorlord.
You teleported us?
Oh, no. You're still comfy cozy with me. I just merged your minds.
Merged our what?
I gave no consent to this, Planescaper.
She's not big on asking permission. It's all pretty sure this and fate of the galaxy that.
Don't you get huffy, God Guy. Your gold hands are all over this mess.
What's that supposed to mean? I thought this guy was how we cure Drax.
Cure and cause can coalesce.
Have you done this before, Mantis? Mantis?
Huh? Oh, sorry. I was distracted.
Guys? Is that... Drax?
I'm Groot.
So we're going into Drax's head. Literally.
Green Meanie's in there somewhere. Find him and convince him to come back to reality.
Mantis, please tell me we're supposed to be going into the bright light.
Pretty sure. You need to reach the heart of Drax's promise. Much deeper than I've ever seen.
Wait, if you've never seen it, does that mean it never happens?
Hope not. Just keep going. And if we lose contact, listen to Amy Winsock.
She means you.
Quite clearly.
Mantis, how are we supposed to find Drax?
Yeah, you got a map for this place?
Whoa. This is Drax's promise? Mine was a lot less downery.
This is just the doorstep. Poor guy was stuck here, reliving the loss of his family.
Your friend's fear and pain primed him as prey.
What do you know about it, Goldilocks?
More than I mind.
There's the big galoot. That was easy.
This is just an echo, little fuzzy. Part of poor Greenie can never stop digging until he accepts what's buried.
I'm not the only one that hears that, right?
Thanks.
We got a runner!
After him, Starlight! I don't know this word!
Drax!
Please be something soft down the... Drax?
Not Drax. Thanos.
Bet you weren't expecting a family reunion, hey Gamora?
I'm gonna enjoy this.
so tough after all.
Something's not right.
You fail to fathom the rules of this realm.
What the?
Okay, that's new. That's new, right?
I think I remember there being two of them.
Twice the ugly, twice the target practice. I got all these toys I'm just dying to use!
Looks like his defenses are down!
Don't you want to lend a hand?
At this rate, we're gonna be outnumbered!
It's like he can't be killed!
As far as Drax is concerned, he probably can't! Watch your back!
You're giving in to poor Greedy's obsession. Only by letting go can you move on.
Abandon the obsession!
Whose side are you on?
Can't just keep this up, can he?
This is all in Drax's mind, remember?
It is a destined defeat.
Is that supposed to mean
Let's
something
try that
to
again,
us?
Shall we?
Ah, Woberry needed help!
Don't get cocky! Remember what Mantis said! Run him through!
Watch your butts!
I'm good.
I don't know! What else are we supposed to do?
Fortune favors failure.
Is that supposed to mean something to us? I can't!
Peter?
Whoa! Hey, what's happening?
That's it! That's why I couldn't see!
Hey! We ain't dead!
Mantis, I think we did something, but I don't see Drax. Mantis?
Your soothsayer holds no sway here. We are trespassers on tainted land.
Guess that means we're in the right place.
Oh, good. Not creepy at all. Hold up! Look!
I bet I could beat you to the center.
Are you so keen to usurp your father?
You're scared to race me.
I only fear you missed the point of this lesson.
Always study your surroundings.
And have you? These walls carry the history of our people. Not so fast, little one. Drax! Wait up!
Chance to have his family back. No wonder Drax couldn't reject the promise.
There he is again!
Drax, buddy! Wait up!
Forced to follow fools.
Damn it!
I can hear you!
You play pawns on a board built by your opponent.
You got a better idea? I'm all ears.
Oh, assuming we ever catch him, what then?
I'm working on that.
Left, little one.
Your friend is too far fallen to be wheeled back by words.
For someone who's been no help, you seem full of opinions on how this works.
It is you who forced me to follow this fantasy of falsehood.
There! Look!
Hey, how did you beat me?
As I am your father. Playing in your mother's garden again.
I was hunting.
Hunting dirt?
No, I chased it, but it was too quick.
Only fools rush forward. A hunter waits, chooses her moment.
Drax.
Papa, are you all right?
Drax, Camaria, it is time to come home.
What the flark is that?
Yes, little one.
Mother waits.
Insidious succubus! Release your thrall!
It's not Kansas anymore.
Mark are those!
Spawn of shadow! Snuff their source while I widen our
They're
way!
They're coming from those nests!
Whatever's keeping us from Drax.
You saw simply its spawn.
That black stuff. I saw something like it in my promise.
There will be more. We have merely moved deeper within its domain.
Speaking of which...
Is that...
Drax's wife. I think so. Hovat.
Then this must be Drax's home.
You two certainly took your time.
Only fools rush.
Come, my love. Let us go inside.
Drax, buddy.
Your words are wasted wind.
Easy, all right. I got this. Come on, big guy. I know you can hear me.
Why do you haunt me?
We're gonna lose him again.
It's me, buddy. Stormlord, remember? We're all here.
You're stronger than this, Drax.
Come on, you big lug. Don't leave me alone with Quill.
Drax, dinner is ready.
That's not Hovat. You gotta let her go.
You do not know what you ask.
Damn it! Just like last time.
Make haste. The maw means to snap shut. I cannot contain it.
There's gotta be a way to show Drax the truth.
Too bad he's missing all this.
I cannot breach the barrier while these denizens defy me.
Work them.
It's not a date, Peter! It's a worm! Kill it!
Who's getting that hug he so desperately needed?
Lock and load, Rocket!
Don't pop a blood vessel!
Tight!
At least these things are satisfying to blow up!
Have a blast, Rocket!
Him blowing you off again.
I blew something up?
Endless entropy. Cease this charade!
Cover your eye holes!
Not good.
Clark in nowhere is where we are.
Maybe it's not all bad. I don't see any new promise, at least.
We are an empty eternal echo. Naked nothingness.
Not helping! Hobo wizard. All right, everyone just split up and look for a way out. Or forward, or whatever.
I lose a bet if I die in a dark pit.
It was alone in a dark pit, and you can't pay me if we're both dead.
Well, at least there's an upside.
Drax! Come on, buddy!
There! Look!
I can't believe that worked.
Let's go. Part of him is still with us, I'm sure of it.
I hope you've got one hell of a speech planned, Peter.
That makes two of us.
Why are you doing this? You not leave me be.
You gotta trust us, Drax. We're trying to help.
By destroying my home.
Your blissful ignorance is an ignoble pursuit.
Easy, Shakespeare. We got this.
Come on. You don't really want to stay in this dark hole?
I would endure the depths of Sarduth to be with my family.
Drax, love. It is time to eat.
I get it, man. They seem really special.
They are the only thing that matters. My Hovat. She was the most fearless mate I've ever known. She brought me peace even during times of war. My Camaria. My innocent little Camaria. She was the best of us both. Despite her meager stature, they both were. My family is gone. What sits before me?
I don't know. But it's not real. It ain't good.
It is a perversion. Fed by desperation.
Without it, I will have nothing. I cannot be alone again.
You're not alone, man. We're here for you.
We've all lost someone, Drax. But it gets easier if you surround yourself with the right people.
I am Groot.
Groot said some mushy stuff. Let's just pretend I said it too. We're a team.
Papa? Are you okay?
Join us, Drax.
It's not her.
Are you hurt, Papa?
Talk to us, love.
I will cherish the time. that we had. And not resent the time that we lost. Shall love and honor you both. Always.
How you doing, big guy? You okay?
I am of sound mind, thanks to you all. I owe amends for my lapse in judgment.
Hey, you don't owe us squat. Ain't none of us perfect. It's kind of our thing.
How much do you remember?
Great darkness grew with every lie that I swallowed. The longer I remained with my family, the more certain I became that I could never leave. Your Quill. Your child is in danger. If her pain is half my own, the darkness may consume her entirely.
Not if I can help it.
We gotta be smart about this. There's a whole lot of converted between us and her.
Whole lot of that black blorf, too. And anyone wanna tell me why Harry Hobo was able to suck it up?
Mortensen, why that thing looked like him?
Because it is me.
Time to go.
Hey, Goldie Braun! Want to get back here and explain that bombshell?
Time is tight and your understanding unimportant.
Can I shoot him? Come on, let me shoot him. That first fight don't count. We got muscles and the bug lady now.
Hey, we're in this together, and smart money says it's gonna be a tough fight.
Even in earnest, you underestimate.
So, anything you can tell us about what we're up against will be a plus.
We're all on the same team. We've gotta work together.
I am in favor of this plan. Goldie Braun seems capable, despite his ridiculous name.
Very well. Imagine ambivalent omnipotence, drifting in darkness.
Speaking of dark...
Such was my celestial solitude. Power without purpose, until uncovered by Raker. His crew were convalescent. Plagued by a pox, I was serendipitously suited to soothe.
A ship full of sick people just happens upon someone with limitless healing?
We were need and needed. Symptom and solace. Worshipped the wonder of my ways and declared me divine.
I think we know where this is going.
I do not know where this is going.
Shh. This is the scary part.
As the flock of followers fawned, a dark delight developed deep within me. And in the shadows it spoke. Weak whelps, pernicious priesting, feeble fools fit for feasting. Hubris made hunger. A cancerous craving called Magus.
What did it want?
Complete devotion. I too heard this voice, and could hear nothing else.
Adulation, flagellation, gorged with grief and consternation.
I told you this was the scary part.
It was pure putrefaction. Sown from the seed of my strength. My soul stone gone sour. I resolved to rip it out.
Rip it out? How?
A mechanical marvel wrought by Raker would sever the stone from my skull and excise the evil entangled within.
Translation, you let Raker steal your powers.
Whatever his wayward wander, he was on that day my friend. He swore to separate sanctity from sin, that my healing could yet be harnessed without harm.
Sure, but who's harnessing it?
I'm with Rocket. Raker knew exactly what he was doing. That man's a master manipulator. Damn it! Now you've got me doing it.
I bear no blame for my fallen friend. Our errant experiment all but broke us both.
Then how do you explain how your best bud got his hands on the stone and has now taken over the galaxy?
I cannot.
I think I can answer that. After I rejected my promise, I got pulled into Nikki's. Pro was there. She was trying to show me something.
Peter, you can't trust anything you saw in there.
This was different, and it felt different. She took me back to the QZ and I saw that Magus thing. I saw it get all twisted up with Nikki and I saw it kill Corel.
You hear yourself? How'd she show you this if she's dead?
Quite conceivable. Her soul may be snared by the stone, chained to the child.
That's what Corel said. The three of them are somehow connected. She said Nikki needs to accept her death.
Magus preys upon her pain, manipulates her mind while feeding on her flock of followers.
And I'm guessing it never gets full.
Its appetite is insatiable. If unassailed, Magus will absorb all.
We're gonna need one hell of a plan.
Well, you better come up with it quick. As I see daylight.
The bond between Magus and Matriarch must be broken. It harvests its hunger through the host.
So, Nikki's like the head vampire. If we cure her, it'll free the rest. Why didn't you just say that?
So step one, find Nikki.
Step two, convince her mom ain't coming back from the dead.
Step three, get that stone away from her and mop the floor with that Magus thing.
You show no shortage of assurance.
Yeah, this one's Mr. Positivity. It's enough to make you sick.
The stone is both bondage and bridge for Magus, and a young mind is most malleable. If Magus has merged with her, she may not survive the severing.
We won't let it come to that.
Not to join the Golden Downer, but how are we supposed to find the kid?
What are you going?
Oh,
Flark.
We've got the cortex. They can go anywhere, convert anyone. Now.
Why does that sound like you're not coming with us?
These are my people. Some still survive if I stay. Then we'll stay and help. Go. I'll be where I'm needed when I need to be. Just trust me.
Don't go dying on me. I'm starting to actually get you. Pop a squat, golden boy, you're making me nervous.
Well, perhaps your nerves need gnawing.
What did I do?
This precarious plan proves more meek by the moment. The Madonna was meant to be among us.
She knows what she's doing. Eventually.
Sorry, sins I have wrought to rest me among such a motley crew.
Did he take my room?
Not so much as a yip from the mic. Groot says he'll keep trying. Where's Mr. Fancy Words?
It is assumed Peter Quill's quarters was a daring display of dominance.
Don't you start.
Usually I'd say who needs him, but we do. So you better fix this one, Quill.
Just try not to piss him off any more than he already is.
If it is to be a fight to the death, I will honor the outcome.
If he kills you, I get your guns.
Wouldn't bet on Peter winning that fight. Took all five of us to beat him last time.
I still can't believe he caught one of my smart bombs. Just like that.
We have already fought the man.
Hold on, you don't remember?
I remember sparring against the Celestial Madonna in a small village. And then the cold darkness of the Promise devouring my soul. Until he found me.
Yeah, you missed a lot.
Kinda glad Loop-the-Loop stayed on Lamentus. My ears were ringing from all her nonsense.
I prefer Mantis's nonsense to Warlock's.
The Golden Man is perfectly intelligible.
Sure, his words make sense. I'm just having trouble with all the pathos.
Yeah, like, what's with the dramatic wardrobe change? Who sleeps in a cocoon and owns a cape?
Capes are nice. I actually dig the cape.
It may be up to us to stop the Church in Nowhere. You ready?
I am Groot.
He's worried about the mutt. Says it would be easier with his help.
I didn't think Cosmo would let the Church take over a station. But if they got the Cortex, then...
He is but one canine against the army of the Converted.
I take it Groot didn't reach Cosmo?
No dice.
The tree is persistent. He will keep trying.
He was the most convinced we could bring you back, you know. I don't know if it's optimism or stubbornness, but it works for him.
Moore, are you okay letting Mantis fight the Church alone out there?
She won't fight. She'll focus on evacuating people. Maybe they can all hide in the caves.
So she's just gonna let the Church take over her homeworld?
Mantis would tell you that people matter more than the planet. And she knows that the Church won't stop coming until we rescue Nikki.
You have great confidence in this Celestial Madonna.
She's one of the few people I know I can trust.
Really? She freaks me out.
Because she's smarter than you?
And kinder.
Hey, that nickname makes my skin crawl. I'm furry, not fuzzy. Not even that little.
My shoulders are sore.
Yeah, Mantis is heavier than she looks.
How is she connected with my soreness?
She rode your back all the way down the caves to Goldie's place.
Really?
Glad you're back on our side, Drax. I got a feeling we'll need to go full destroyer on this one.
I shall be ready, Peter Quill. I have witnessed the threat posed by Magus firsthand. No one should suffer from its malignant lies. I owe all of you a great debt of gratitude. It would be my honor to fight beside you with all of my might.
That's a lot of might. Groot agrees with you, Muscles.
Sounds like we've got ourselves a nice Church butt-kicking party.
I only hope our guest agrees to join this buttock-striking celebration.
Hey, Quill.
You seem like you're in a good mood.
Do I? I've got a great idea for a new blaster extension. Can't wait to put it together.
Well, now that the gang's back together and we've got a minute to breathe, I think you deserve an official thank you for what you did on Lamentus.
Quill,
I know you don't like that kind of sappy stuff, but I really mean it. Knowing about the crap those scientists did to you, not only does it make my blood boil, it puts everything into perspective.
Come on. It was just a puddle.
I don't know if I could have gotten over something like that.
You saved our lives, man. You deserve a bit of praise.
We rode and saved your lives, and scientists were involved. I have many questions.
Yeah, well, save them for the next time we all get a drink together, buddy.
If you ask for a rubber ducky grenade, I'm gonna bite your toes off. Here you go. All right, it's all yours. Done in record time. Oof, got a crick in my back because of that.
Half-World must have been a nightmare. I hope this makes you feel a little less alone. All right. Let the waves of calm wash over me. And go.
That's not how that works.
Oh, Gamora!
Since when do you meditate?
I don't, but desperate times and all. Stuff's been a lot lately.
I get it. Allah help me, do I get it.
So, how do you use this then? In case, you know, Rocket asks.
Well, for one, it isn't about just holding it. You also need a comfortable place to sit, where you can be relaxed but alert, and focus on your breathing. Then you practice. A lot.
Yeah, that sounds like a lot more work than I was hoping for.
Anything worth doing tends to be.
So how do you do it?
Focus was something Thanos beat into us early on. But it wasn't until I lived with the priests of Palma that I realized how limited his version of meditation really was.
I can't picture Thanos meditating. I kind of always figured he was this egotistical tyrant.
No, he totally was. But Thanos also understood that aspects of meditation could be useful to his cause.
Like focus?
Focus, increasing overall awareness, pain tolerance. He came up with a series of exercises, fun little games for me and Nebula to compete in as part of our training. The worst part was, we didn't even know what he was doing until it was too late.
What do you mean?
Thanos' brand of meditation warped us, turned us into hyper-focused weapons. That way we were numb to the horrors of his agenda.
Killing people.
Assassination is just a different name for murder.
So how did you cope?
We made puns. Bad, stupid jokes to shout as we were killing people. The more terrible, the better.
Here, I thought you just had a really lame sense of humor.
Oh, I do. But it was the only way to survive. And it was something we did together, a new kind of competition, just between me and Nebula, to see who can make the other laugh.
That's really messed up, and yet oddly endearing.
Yeah, well, even bad puns can only get you so far before your conscience catches up with you.
How did you end up living with the priests of Palma? They're not exactly your kind of crowd with the whole pacifism thing.
Mantis introduced me to them last year, when I needed to heal. They helped me in ways I didn't think were possible.
Helped? How?
I guess you could say I was broken. Thanos, the war, working as an assassin, it'd take a toll on you. By the time Mantis brought me there, I was ready to give up. I mean, I was miserable. Convinced I was beyond redemption or worth, I truly believed I deserved to die.
But you didn't die.
No. There was this boy there. A Khan.
The one you hugged in the village.
A Khan was like me. Lost. His parents had died in an accident. He was combative, rebellious, the opposite of a pacifist. The priest thought it would be a good idea for both of us to work through our scut together.
And was it?
At first, not really. He was a pain in the butt. But over time, we came to rely on each other. Thanos had taught me how to meditate in the functional sense, but not in the spiritual sense. Like, how to work through my trauma. Caring for a Khan, he forced me to reflect and process. And together, through mutual support, a Khan and I were able to overcome our demons.
Wow. I had no idea meditation could be so intense.
Or beneficial?
Well, yeah, that too. I guess I should give it a go sometime. Although I'm kind of scared of what I'll find.
Who knows? You might surprise yourself. I know I did.
Yeah, maybe. No wonder Gamora's so patient with us.
Rodent, you mentioned the Madonna riding my shoulders through the caves.
Yep.
There was more than one cave, then.
You really don't remember anything at all?
I have a vague recollection of dampness.
Yep, that would be the caves.
Did you just...
You have closed the refrigerator door.
Yeah, I do that sometimes.
I thought I was the only one who ever bothered.
I thought I was the only one.
I observed the tree closing at once. Please, recount your adventures in the caves of Lamentis. I should be informed of what I cannot recall.
Well, we found you in the village and Mantis knocked you out. Then we went down the caves until we found the cocoon.
Whoa there, you missed all the best parts. Like when Groot slapped the ancient tree god. Yeah, it was in the way.
Tree for a god. Impressive.
Would a wanton hand supply sustenance to this chamber?
He's asking for room service now.
Come get your own. We've got a full fridge.
Well, not exactly full.
So, Warlock, he's something.
Not sure we can trust the guy who looked at the Grand Unicorn himself and thought, the lad looks like a reliable rascal.
He simply knows that the true evil is Magus. Laker is but an impressionable fanatic.
A fanatic with a lot of firepower.
I always thought Gamora would eat her young. Oh. He didn't light it.
Peter Quill, I did not expect to find you in here.
Hey, sorry. I didn't mean to...
It is fine. Your company is always welcome. And thank you for the gift.
Oh, yeah. Sure. Figured you might want to light it from time to time in memory of your family.
Why would a lit candle remind me of my family? Every memory I have of them has been carved into my flesh.
You... What?
The red scars that I bear. They are a record of every great deed, an important milestone in my life.
Oh. I just thought it was because they look cool.
No, Peter Quill. On Katath, we practice scarification, so that there is a record, proof, that one is worthy to enter Ul'tath. Such a record is required for judgment in the afterlife.
So, hypothetically speaking, if you died tomorrow, what would happen?
My Cho'tak, my life essence, would travel to the gates of Ul'tath. There I will be judged by the great kings and queens of ages past. And if deemed worthy, the gates will open.
And if you're not, you know, worthy?
The gates do not open.
And...
I am cast into Sarduth, where I will cease to exist.
Yeah. I guess that's bad. So, like, how do these kings and queens know if you're worthy?
By reading the scars that make up my life record. From that, they will judge whether I'm worthy. For some, a life of meaning comes from their trade. For others, their family. And others yet, from following the warrior's path. Each is a valid entry into the gates of Ul'tath. Hence the record.
What happens if you don't have a record?
Ah. Like yourself.
Sure. Like me, what happens to someone like me? Do I just immediately get thrown into Sarduth?
No, Peter Quill. Your record is instead given by those who knew you in life.
Ooh, yeah. I might have some problems.
Doubtful. I've seen your dedication to the Kree child and woman, and to this crew, and what you did for me. It is a testament to your worthiness.
Thanks. So, your tattoos are actually a record of your life that's been carved into your skin?
Yes. The process is known as the Jil'Tara, and is extremely painful. It requires focus and self-control, and occurs many times in a Katathian's life.
No offense, Drax, but they just look like a bunch of swirly lines.
Perhaps to you. To me, they are the most important moments of my life. Each line is composed of 1,000 scars, each engraved with the tooth of a walnut creature.
What kind of moments get recorded? Kill counts? Stuff like that?
No, Peter Quill. A Catathian life record is a record of just that. Major milestones and important events. Like the day I became a man.
Gross.
And the day that Hovat accepted my proposal of marriage. And later, the marriage ceremony itself. And the day that Hovat gave birth to my daughter, Camaria. And the day that I lost them both.
Now I see why they're scars.
Yes. Once I believed my failure to avenge their deaths had banished us all to Sarduth. But now, thanks to you and the others, I see a deeper truth. Life does not have meaning without suffering as well.
If anyone deserves a happy afterlife, Drax, it's you. Think you'll be adding any more to your tattoos?
Yes.
Like maybe a Guardians of the Galaxy logo?
Perhaps.
Good enough for me. You deserve to join your family in Altath, buddy.
What happened after you entered the caves?
It was all moist and gross inside.
I am Groot.
Only you would find that amazing.
The cave network was huge. We had to go down several cliffs.
Ah, with the girl on my shoulders.
Yes. Oh, and Drax, there was the part where you attacked us and straight up jumped into a ravine.
I jumped into a ravine.
You jumped at me, but I dodged.
How could I survive the fall?
Starpants did another one of his magic gun tricks and yoinked you out of there.
Oh, right! Peter's guns had another hidden setting.
Another? Oh, what an adventure.
I don't think that's where Golden Boy went to.
He's in your cabin if you're looking for him, Peter.
I know. Hey, that one's from Lamentus. Does that mean it's a sacred plant? Groot, did you steal a sacred plant from Lamentus? Good thing we stashed rocket stuff in here. That weapons upgrade really saved our butts against Captain What's-His-Face.
You're welcome!
I am optimistic about Peter Quill convincing our guests to fight alongside us.
Of course you'd be optimistic. You're always optimistic.
Optimism or not, we need to work with him. We need someone strong enough to keep Raker in check if we want any chance to get to Nikki.
Hey, Warlock. Open up. This is my room, you know. And that would be my cassette cover.
You penned this pithy poetry?
It's not poetry, it's music. Hard rock. It's supposed to have guitars and bass and drums.
Simplistic scriptures, as is its scribe.
Okay, what's your deal, man? What did I do to piss you off?
Your lamentable leadership allowed the Madonna to leave when we needed her talents to travel to the telepathic realm.
Mantis had good reason to stay behind. We just need to get Nikki and get the hell out so we can find her again.
Your tenuous tactics trust too much to fortune. Can you confidently convince me your meager measures may amply manage this mission?
My meager what?
Your meager metal. We stand against an adversary unlike any before. Blinded by burning, hope-fueled hate.
Magus, right, your evil twin. That's our adversary.
Before such a blaze, still a stooge may steer. but your wide-eyed wonder is merely wit and moxie. You strut as an insecure cock, uncertain of his stature.
Does that mean what I think it means?
This audacity acts as stilts on sand as the tide thralls you in. Leading must be wrought off the fullness of your yearning yoke. Will it be so?
Yes, absolutely.
Wise words, sure and measured, but be held by my bemused misgivings. Your demeanor differs distinctly in direction from my more willful ways.
Maybe we can meet in the middle then.
Yes, an oath. Will you own an oath to operate with greater aggression? To give gravitas to gravid seasons of your soul and struggle not to stand on destiny's icy flows?
Sure, man. Whatever it takes.
Then assert it.
I swear I'll be a good leader, that I'll be decisive, that I won't let Manus do whatever she wants.
I stand partially reassured.
What about you, Mr. Fancy Words? How do I know you won't see Raker and have a change of heart?
Why would I weasel away?
Didn't you used to be best buds with him?
We were common company for a fleeting fallow, through which I witnessed the incommensurable extent of his sadness. He mourns his lost son.
That's why he's doing all of this. The church, the matriarch? Because he wants to get his kid back. But that can't happen, right? Magus can't...
No. Cannot.
So? We can count on you? When you reunite with Raker, that man's gotta go down.
Indubitably.
After Peter Quill pulled me out of the ravine, that is when you found the Golden Man?
So, how is he?
Frustrating. It's like talking to Suzanne Harris at the summer dance all over again.
Ain't that the Humi girl you tried to impress with your yo-yo skills?
Yeah, and it went about as well as talking to Mr. Cape.
What's a yo-yo?
Yeah, I heard you. Ain't gonna get craftsmanship like that anywhere else.